The three-day summit organized by the Inter-African Coffee Organization will run from the 7th of August at the Speak Resort Munyonyo under the theme Transforming the African Coffee Sector Through Value Addition, with the aim of promoting the commodity's consumption mainly on the African continent. A number of heads of state, senior government ministers, heads of coffee authorities, senior ministers from African coffee-consuming countries and African private sector groups, including farmers, processors, exporters, roasters and coffee associations are expected to be in attendance. Now, police spokesman Fred Enanga says security has been tightened for officials of the G25 African countries.
The joint security agencies, we have our security personnel, both overt and covert, who have been deployed to police this regional summit.
Security in the Kampala metropolitan area says they have arrested one of the notorious city gang leaders, Mbazira Ronald, and recovered a gun following an operation within the city.
And he was on our wanted list because when we were taking him for medical examination at Katwe, he managed to escape from the detectives who were negligent. And so he shifted his criminal base from here to Nyendo. Mukungwe division, but we managed to track him down. We have managed to fast track some of the cases where he was actively involved, and we now have 13 cases of aggravated robbery against him, 8 within Kampala area and additional 5 cases in Greater Masaka.
More Ugandans have been killed in South Sudan. Enanga says 4 people were killed last week. However, the bodies of the victims were recovered by the UPDF. Police have also arrested 4 people, including a UPDF officer, for smuggling timber from a forest. He said they violated the order issued by the president.
In the course of last week, we lost 4 Ugandans. They were killed from Ayiba village in South Sudan. The UPDF managed to retrieve the 4 bodies, which included that of Okwera Morris, aged 34, from Madi Ope in Lamu, Komakech Salufa, 27, Yewi Patrick, 33, and Nyeko Alan. Our territorial commanders from both the UPDF and police are trying to engage with counterparts from the other side, because we are told that they were murdered by SPLA from Owing Kibul Training School.
The Chief of Police, Martin Okoth Ochola, also congratulated the Cranes on achieving the 5th position in the world and number 1 position in Africa. However, Enanga has asked those who enjoy sports in public places to be vigilant. Also, police have arrested a number of foreigners over passport fraud. The Ministry of Internal Affairs has also seized over 10,000 genuine Ugandan national IDs belonging to foreigners who were attempting to acquire the country's passports.
We realized that at the time we started issuing national IDs, we did not have a national data bank. Therefore, whoever would come with all sorts of information, I think it would be entertained. That's why we accumulated that whooping number of 10,000 fraudulently acquired national IDs. But over time, we are scooping them out. And I think with time, we shall succeed to completely rid society of non-citizens who are fraudulently carrying these national IDs.
Also, those with old passports have been encouraged to get their new passports. The ministry is also training staff to improve the quality of their work. And soon, passport services will be made mobile.
So whoever carries this passport will not be granted entry into the country or will not be granted exit out of the country. So I call upon Ugandans out there with this type of passports who have not renewed passports to please come to our offices, which are open, and do so. For you to apply for a passport, ladies and gentlemen, you just have to go to our portal www.passports.go.ug. That one will lead you to an easy form to fill, very user-friendly, and where you have to put your details, such as name, date of birth, and stuff like that. And then after you pay 250,000, I must emphasize this, payment for ordinary passport is 250,000 when you are living here, and you don't have to add a coin. And please avoid using brokers, because brokers have caused a lot of mayhem to the public applying for passports.
Meanwhile, NIRA spokesperson Osborne Mushabe has warned people against changing their age since it will affect their pension. He says those found guilty will be fined or imprisoned for 6 months or both.
Ataka wa ilu nambata no mukaga, oba section 56. Ewa minister wa internal affairs, akule mbele chitongole cha NIRA, obuyinza.
The deputy police spokesperson, Luke Owesijire, has explained circumstances under which one Semakula Kamada, a border driver, was shot by a night security guard at Starbucks petrol station. Police in Kasangati are also investigating a case of murder where two brothers were beaten and one succumbed to injuries.
In the motorcycle, he gave the attendant 10,000 Ugandan shillings. That is one Nairuba, Caroline. However, Nairuba alleges that the note was stolen and wanted Kamada to replace the note. So Kamada was very sure that was a legal tender. So he stubbornly had to ride away. And while he was riding away, it is alleged that the security guard attached to Starbucks petrol station, Kiplangat Joshua, who works with Night Security Company, which has its head offices in Mukono, shot at him in the buttocks. So he has been rushed to Mulago, where he is currently receiving treatment. We condemn such acts.
From traffic police, 405 accidents occurred last week. According to the spokesperson of the traffic police, Superintendent of Police Michael Kananura, he has given details on the nature of the accidents. Report compiled by Sulaiman Mutebi for the news.